Hello friends, today we are going to see 50 protected areas in news. UPSC in Civil Services preliminary examination asks almost 2 to 3 questions based on this protected area. If you could see those protected areas, they are not asked in a random way. They are identified and picked from the current affairs. So what we have done here is we have made a list of 50 important protected areas in the news spanning from June 2019 to April 2020. So these 50 protected areas will cover national parks, wildlife sanctuaries and tiger reserves. So by studying these 50 protected areas, we can target those 4 marks or 6 marks which UPSC is going to ask. So what I have done is we are going to study this 50 protected areas as a 5 part video. So daily we are going to see 10 protected areas in a part. Okay. Today we will see part 4 of this series. Already we have discussed part 1, 2 and 3 where we saw 30 other national parks. So see these previous videos before seeing this video guys. So today we will see another 10. So in today's session we will be seeing the protected areas in these 3 states, that is Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. We are going to discuss the southern state. Already we discussed the 2 protected areas from Kerala. So the first protected area in today's video is Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary. This Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary is in news because of the death of a few elephant in the recent times. There has been nearby to Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary, there is a lot of farm field, agricultural fields. So farmers there are having electric fences to protect their fields from animal. Meaning a lot of elephants are getting electrocuted because of this electric fence around the farms. So that's why it was in news. So there has been cases of several wild elephants dying of electrocution near Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary. So that's why it is in news. As the name suggests, this Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary is located on the banks of Kaveri River. So Kaveri River forms the boundary for this protected area. If you could see in the map, it forms the boundary for the protected area. So that's why it got its name Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary. And it has a very diversified fauna in that, like it is having crocodiles, then it is having otters, and the most important thing is humpbacked machir. In 2019 prelims, there was a question. The UPSC used to ask like this new model, like species and rivers. So in this model, they asked the question in that the first option they gave was machir and some other river. So since machir is in Kaveri, we know that. So it was a wrong thing. So likewise, UPSC is asking question. So you have to be very careful about knowing the species in the protected area. So machir fish is in the Kaveri River. So see, if you could see, it is exactly in the border. Here you are having Tamil Nadu and it is located in the border. And this is the Kaveri River which is flowing. See, if you could see here, Kaveri River is flowing here. And it is flowing through the park and then entering the Tamil Nadu. So it is exactly in the border of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. So this is the zoomed image of the protected area. See, this area is having a lot of protected areas. You know, Western Ghats is very dense here. So Western Ghats is very dense here. So it is having a lot of protected area in this region, and that region is being shown here. And see this. This is Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary, and the Kaveri River will flow like this. So south to that, we are having various other protected areas which we will see. So this is Biligiri Ranganatha Temple Tiger Reserve, Satyamangalam Tiger Reserve in Tamil Nadu, Mudumalai Tiger Reserve. Here we are having Vandipur, Vayanad and Nagarhol, Brahmagiri. So this region consists of a dense tiger population. This continuous region here is having the highest density of tiger population all over India. With respect to state, we know that Madhya Pradesh is having the highest. With respect to a single extended protected region, this region is having the maximum number of tigers. So that is the speciality of this region. The second protected area for today is Ranganathittu Wildlife Sanctuary. So, as the name suggests, Tittu means it is something which is formed in the water, that is island in the water. So, Ranganathittu is a riverine island which is formed in the Kaveri River. It was mainly formed because of the dam constructed. So, in the course of Kaveri, they constructed a dam. A lot of water was stored here. So, after the dam in the downstream, there will be fall in the flow of river. So, since the river flow was falling, a lot of settlements got settled here itself. So, if the river is flowing, the settlements would have gone to the delta. But since there is a dam here, there is a slowdown, it changed from mature stage to old stage because of this dam. So, because of that, a lot of settlement took place and that led to the form of the island within the Kaveri. We are having another famous riverine island in Tamil Nadu also. It is called Srirangam. So, the same, like how Srirangam was formed, the same thing led to the formation of Ranganathittu Bird Sanctuary. So, it is in news because of, it is one of the densest and largest bird sanctuary in Karnataka. And it is having various types of birds. So, Forest Department of Karnataka decided to do a bird count there. A bird census is being conducted in the Ranganathittu Bird Sanctuary in their continuing efforts to prepare a scientific database for the better management. Just to have an idea that what are all the total number of birds coming so that we can manage the national park scientifically. It is also known as Pakshi Kashi. UPSC tend to ask questions in the form of riddles. There are riddle type questions. Like this national park is having the highest bird density in Karnataka. It is also called as Pakshi Kashi of Karnataka. It is located in Peninsular India. So likewise, it is located on the Western Ghats. Likewise, they will be gluing. And which of the following national park is being discussed? Likewise, riddle based questions are coming in UPSC. So in those kind of questions, these kind of words, if they are giving in the riddle, we can easily identify it. So we will not be knowing all the facts which they are giving in the question, but such important peculiar points, with that only we can find. So one such point is Pakshikashi. So it is called as Kasi. Kasi is a place where sacred place for all the human beings. It is Pakshikashi means it is a sacred place for all the birds, because since a lot of birds are coming there, it is considered to be Kasi because a lot of humans are going to Kasi. It is the largest bird sanctuary in the state and comprises of 6 islands. So it comprises of a group of 6 islands in the Kaveri River. Over 200 migratory species and Indian birds and at least 60,000 in number arrive here every year for nesting and breeding. Since it is a, see, nesting and breeding site is a very important site for migratory birds. So, but migratory birds may pass by whenever they are flying in a flyway. They will pass by and they will come to a wetland. They will be eating and they will be drinking water, and then they will be continuing their journey. So that is just feeding site. But nesting and breeding site is means it is having a different meaning. Where they come here, where they nest, where they mate, and they lay egg. So it is very important with respect to the migratory birds. That's why this area should be protected. So nesting and breeding ground for all the migratory birds should be protected, so that it deals with the biodiversity of entire world, not only with respect to Karnataka or India. So if you could see here, it is located in the banks of Kaveri. So this is the Kaveri River which is coming. See, there is a huge reservoir here. Since there is a dam constructed here, there is a huge reservoir here. After this reservoir, immediately you are having this Paranganathittu bird sanctuary. This is the river and these are all the islands. See, this is one island, this is another island. These are all few small islands located here. So entire all these islands together comprises of the Ranganathittu. And if you could see, the dams will be here. So the next protected area in news is Bandipur Tiger Reserve. So Bandipur Tiger Reserve is another famous tiger reserve located in India, and it was in news recently because of what? Because of the famous Man vs. Wild by Talaivar. Man vs. Wild program of Rajini. Rajini participated in the Man vs. Wild, so that's why Bandipur was in news. And our Prime Minister participated in Man vs. Wild, and that was taken in Corbett National Park of Uttarakhand. So, but Bandipur is in news for some other reason, because of the highway which is going from Wayanad to Mysore, the famous National Highway 766. So that's why it was in news. National Tiger Conservation Authority has convened an interstate meeting of senior forest personnel. So what they have done is, it has called for a joint meeting of forest official from Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Kerala for joint protection. Like in previous video, we saw that Bhutan, Nepal and India are jointly going to protect that as a entire peace park. So likewise, let us protect this area through joint protection. So this Bandipur Tiger Reserve is located in the tri-junction of all the three states, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So since it is located in the tri-junction, we need the cooperation of all the three. And just now I said it is one of the having highest tiger density in all over India. So they decided to conserve the ecosystem through joint efforts. So that is why they convened a meeting. That's why it was in news. Okay, that is one reason why it was in news. Another reason why it was in news was the highway passing through. There is this famous highway, National Highway 766, which is passing from Wayanad to Mysore. So this is the highway. This highway is starting from Wayanad and it is going through Mudumalai National Park, Bandipur Tiger Reserve, and then it is going to Mysore here. This is passing through a major protected area. So that's why what happened, since it is passing through the protected area, a lot of animals were killed during the night times because of this traffic of the vehicles coming in the night time. So government Karnataka government and Union government decided to close this highway for night traffic. The night traffic was closed in this highway, okay, in 2009 to protect the wildlife in the area. Then later a lot of people in Wayanad. See, Wayanad is a hill station and this highway is one of the important lifeline for them to get connected with Karnataka. If this highway is closed in the night, it is affecting the transportation and the economy of the artisans and the small farmers who are in Wayanad. Since the farmers are being affected there, all these farmers were protesting for opening up of this highway. Since then, they filed a case in Supreme Court, and Supreme Court also upheld the ban. Supreme Court upheld the night ban, and what it said in recent judgment was, find alternative routes to this highway from Wayanad to Mysore. There is another route like this. So this is passing through Bandipur. So you close this highway permanently, find an alternative route and make this route feasible. This is what the Supreme Court gave the judgment, and it also upheld the night traffic ban. After this judgment, there was huge protest again in Wayanad region. So that's why this Bandipur Tiger Reserve is in news again. It connects Karnataka and Kerala, passes through Bandipur Tiger Reserve. It was declared National Highway in 1989. Initially, it was National Highway 212. So, initially, it was 212. Later, it was changed name in the new series. So, in 2016, they renumbered the highways. When the renumbering was done, it was renumbered to NH7. So, it serves as a survival route for the people in Wayanad. People in Wayanad are not having proper rail or water connectivity. This is one of the two roads. One road connects Wayanad with Kerala and other roads connect Wayanad with Karnataka. So, if this one important lifeline for the Wayanad or the entry of the Wayanad is closed, that will affect the livelihood of people in Wayanad, and that's why they are protesting. So, another important fact with respect to the Bandipur Tiger Reserve is that Moyar River, originating in the Nilgiri Mountains, is flowing through this river. So, Moyar River is a tributary of Bhavani. So, Moyar River goes and joins the Bhavani, and Bhavani is the tributary of what? Bhavani is a tributary of Kaveri. So, Moyar is a sub-tributary of Kaveri. So, Moyar River is actually separating the Bandipur and the Satyamangalam. Bandipur and Mudumalai. So, it is a very important river flowing in this region. So, if you could see, this is the road which we already saw. It is starting from Wayanad and it is going through Mudumalai and Bandipur, and it is reaching the Mysore. So, what government is, instead of following this, what is Supreme Court said was, create this as an alternate route. So, you develop this as a highway which goes to Mysore. Okay, instead of following this Mudumalai Bandipur route, follow this Mannanthavadi route. So, Mannanthavadi route, Wayanad Mannanthavadi and Mysore route should be made an alternative route. That is what they said. And you also know Ooty is located here. So, from Ooty, another road comes and joins this road here, and from that is also creating a problem. If you could see here, from Ooty, there is another road which is going to Bandipur, and it is getting connected to the already existing route. This is another route which is creating problem, which should also be checked. So, according to recent forest official data, ever since the night traffic was closed, in the past 10 years, the number of road kills has fell down 3 times. It fell down 3 times. So, it is a very good improvement according to the latest forest officials. So, the next is Malai Mahadeshwara Wildlife Sanctuary. This Malai Mahadeshwara Wildlife Sanctuary is again a protected area which is located in the same Karnataka-Tamil Nadu border. So, Malai Mahadeshwara Wildlife Sanctuary was in use because it is to be declared as Tiger Reserve soon. Like already we saw, they decided to declare Guru Ghasidas as a Tiger Reserve, then Ratpani Wildlife Sanctuary as a Tiger Reserve. So, after that, apart from Guru Ghasidas in Chhattisgarh and Ratpani in Madhya Pradesh, Malai Mahadeshwara Wildlife Sanctuary is also to be declared as Tiger Reserve soon. So, there are 3 areas which are to be declared as Tiger Reserve soon in the news. Also, in this notification, after this notification, Karnataka will have 6 Tiger Reserve apart from Nagarhol, Bhadra, Anshi Dandeli, Bandipur, Biligali Rangarambada Swami Temple. Malai Mahadeshwara Wildlife Sanctuary is located in the Chamrajanagar district of Karnataka. This Chamrajanagar district of Karnataka is the border district between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Once it is notified, this district will itself have 3 Tiger Reserve. We'll see. Apart from Bandipur and Biligiri Ranganatha Swami Temple Tiger Reserve, it will be the 3rd Tiger Reserve in this same single district itself. So, note the name of the district. This district is having 3 Tiger Reserve. So, this can also be a statement also. The Chamrajanagar district consists of 3 Tiger Reserve. This can also be given as a statement. So, just have a note about this particular district. So, this is the map of Karnataka, and this is the Chamrajanagar district, which is located in the border of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. And if you could see in this particular district, there is Biligiri Ranganatha Swami Temple Tiger Reserve, which is already existing. Apart from the Biligiri Ranganatha Swami Temple, you are also having the Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary. So, Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary, Biligiri Ranganatha Swami Temple Tiger Reserve, and a new Tiger Reserve is going to come in this region. Okay. So, this Tiger Reserve, Kaveri will be in the north and Biligiri Ranganatha Swami will be in the west, and this Tiger Reserve will be here, which will be in the border. So, this is the Malai Mahadeshwara Wildlife Sanctuary, which is going to be located here. This region, you just note down this region and all the national parks which are located here. They can also ask the national parks which arrange the following in the west to east or east to west, like Kaveri, then we are having Malai Mahadeshwara, then we are having Satyamangalam, then Biligiri Ranganatha Swami Temple, then Mudumarai Bandipur, then we are having Nagarhol. They can also ask like this also, questions like this. So, you have to note this thing also. So, the 5th Tiger Reserve. So, we finished with respect to Karnataka. In Karnataka, we saw Malai Mahadeshwara, Bandipur Tiger Reserve. We saw Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary. We also discussed about the Ranganathittu Bird Sanctuary. So, apart from these 4 things in Karnataka, next we are going to Tamil Nadu. So the first one in Tamil Nadu is the famous Mudumalai Tiger Reserve. You all know Mudumalai is famous for the elephants, and it is in use also for the same reason. So recently the elephant rejuvenation camp was inaugurated in Mudumalai Tiger Reserve. Recently rejuvenation camp for captive elephants. It is not for the wild elephants, it is for the captive elephants. Captive elephants mean those elephants which are used for the domestic purposes. Domestic purpose means in temple and for the other entertainment and ritual purposes. So ritual purposes in temple. So these are all the captive elephants. So these, for these elephants, they have set up a rejuvenation camp. So the Pajuja will be thinking, what is the purpose of the rejuvenation camp? See, elephants are wild animals. If you are taking that and using that in temple, their nature is to live in the wild region with the trees and with the forest with the wind on the face. So what is happening when you bring that elephants to the temple and for domestic purpose, they are missing that wind on the face. That elephant is out of its ecosystem for a long period of time. That will lead to the, that will make the elephant angry, and it will create psychological issues for the elephant, and that might lead to make that elephant wild also. So that's why every year you have to take that elephant for the rejuvenation camp for some mental treatment. So that's why they are doing it. Okay. And it will enrich its health also. So Mudumalai Tiger Reserve is located in the Nilgiris district of Tamil Nadu, and it is in the tri-junction of Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. We all know this. Mudumalai means ancient hill range. This hill range where the Mudumalai is located is formed 65 million ago. Okay, 65 million years ago when Western Ghats was formed. That's why it is called as Mudumalai. It is one of the oldest geological region. It is also part of the Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve, the first biosphere reserve in India. So that is Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve is the first biosphere reserve in India. Elephant grass, bamboos and teak is found here. So this is the important floras growing in the region. Elephant grass is also, see, Mudumalai la there is elephant grass. There are not only elephant but also elephant grass. Elephant grass are tall and thick grasses. Bamboos also grown here and teak wood is also grown here. So which means that it is having deciduous vegetation. So this is the map of the same region. In the previous thing we saw a colorful map. Now it is a green colored one map. So this is the Bandipur. Bandipur is in the north and Mudumalai is the south to Bandipur. So Mudumalai is located here in the tri-junction of all the three states. It is spread to all the three states. See, Mukurthi National Park is in the south, Bandipur is in the north, and we are having Bayanad in the west. So the next protected area in the news is Mukurthi National Park. Mukurthi National Park is also in Tamil Nadu Kerala border. It is in TN Kerala border. It is another important national park in Tamil Nadu. So Mukurthi National Park is known for its forest fires. Forest fires occur here very often. So in order to prevent the forest fires in this region, what they are doing, they will be constructing these fire lines. So the meaning of the fire lines means, see, if this is the forest consisting of full of vegetation, what they will do, if there is a fire in this end, that fire might spread. See, if this is the having entirely vegetation, what will happen? If there is a fire in this end, that fire will spread fully and it will burn the entire forest. In order to avoid that, what they will do, if this is the protected area, they will be drawing a line like this in the center, and they will be removing all the trees in the center. See, if this is the direction of the wind, in the majority of the year, then the fire will be growing from this direction to this direction. So they will be creating a fire line here. So what will happen? There will be a gap in the vegetation in this region. So if the fire is coming, this entire region will be burned, and the fire will be stopped here because there is no vegetation to burn here. So vegetation in this side will be protected. So this is called as fire line technique. See, if the air movement is like this in this direction, then what they will do, they will construct a fire line in this direction. So these are all the use of fire lines. In the February month of 2020, authorities are going to Mukurthi National Park were constructing these fire lines throughout the park in order to prevent the forest fire in the region. Fire line is an artificial break formed in the foliage or forest cover to control the spread of the forest fire. Okay, Mukurthi National Park is located on the northwest corner of Tamil Nadu, that is in the border of Tamil Nadu and Kerala. It is part of the Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve along with Mudumalai Wildlife Sanctuary, Bandipur, Nagarhole. Just now we saw in the map also. We'll see the map. The keystone species in the region is Nilgiri Thar. So it is state animal of Tamil Nadu, and it is in endangered status. It is in endangered status. It is Varayadu. Varayadu in Tamil. So that is Nilgiri Thar. That is the main keystone species in the Mukurthi National Park. Okay. So if they are asking a riddle with respect to Mukurthi National Park, they can insert this fact. It is having the Nilgiri Thar as the keystone species. So likewise only they will be doing. They will add this fact. It is in the northwest corner of Tamil Nadu. So you have to note these things. Okay. There has been almost 27% increase in the population of Nilgiri Thar over last few years because this is acting as a thriving region for the Nilgiri Thar, because there is a lot of vegetation for the goats to eat. It is having mountain grasslands and shrublands. Okay. Like the previous two which we saw, Mudumalai and Bandipur, they having deciduous vegetation, and this is having shrubland and grassland vegetation. That's why you have to cut the fire line in the grasses to prevent the forest fire. So, Mukurthi National Park, if you could see, this is in the tip of the border between Tamil Nadu and Kerala. It is located exactly in the this border in the Nilgiri district. So, the zoomed picture, if you could see, this is the Mukurthi National Park. Mukurthi National Park is just located north of the Silent Valley. See, Silent Valley is another famous national park in the region. This can also be part of the riddle. If Mukurthi is asked, it is located in the, to the north of Silent Valley National Park. Okay, it is located near the Nilambur Lake. So, this is the Nilambur Lake. It is located near the Nilambur Lake. So, likewise only they will be asked the riddles. So, it is located to the east of the Nilambur Lake and north of the Silent Valley National Park. So, the next protected area in the news is Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary. So, we finished Tamil Nadu. In Tamil Nadu, we just saw Mudumalai and Mukurthi. Only two things we saw. So, now let us start with the Andhra Pradesh. So, Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary is located in the Andhra Pradesh. So, Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary in the Chittoor district. So, why it is in news was Mudumalai Wildlife Sanctuary is having a lot of elephants and this region is having a lot of elephants. So, because of various regions like human-animal conflict and destruction of habitat, a few elephants started from this Mudumalai and Satyamangalam forest divisions and they started to migrate towards Andhra Pradesh. So, this is TN and you are having Andhra Pradesh in this region. If the elephant goes in this direction, they can go to Andhra Pradesh. So, a lot of elephants started to move here. And another group of elephants also moved from Banargeta National Park and they migrated to Andhra Pradesh in search of food and fodder. Since this Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary is having a lot of very rich in water sources, so these elephants settled here. But after a decade, what is happening? All these elephants are suffering because there has been habitat destruction in Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary also. So, this has led to a lot of human-animal conflict in the Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary region. And apart from that, recently a group of elephants died of starvation. Worldwide, a lot of people are dying out of starvation. So, now even animal kingdom is dying out of starvation without any food because of the human-animal conflict and the habitat destruction. So, that's why it was in news. Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary, it is in Chittoor district. Recently, 6 out of 41 elephants. So, there, in this Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary, there are 41 elephants which migrated and came there. 6 of them died due to various reasons like electrocution, communicable diseases spreading, scarcity of fodder, that is a major reason, and water, shrinking of habitat due to encroachment on forest fringes, and old age. A lot of elephants, the 6 elephants died, it was in news. This sanctuary is covered by dry deciduous forest again. Okay. So, dry deciduous and thorn forest. Since it's located in Andhra Pradesh, always have this in mind. Andhra Pradesh having a lot of red sanders. So, red sanders are always dry deciduous. In the last decade, elephants have been migrating more than ever before looking for habitable forest and they came here and here also they are facing a problem now. So, that is the plight of the elephants. So, this is the map of the Andhra Pradesh and if you could see here, this is the Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary. Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary is exactly in the Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh border. So, this is the Chittoor district and it is in the border. So, these elephants from Karnataka and Tamil Nadu migrated from the Vayanamad, Satyamangalam and Banargeta National Park to Kaundinya Wildlife Sanctuary here. So, the next protected area which we are going to see in Andhra Pradesh is Nagarjuna Srisailam Tiger Reserve. This Nagarjuna Srisailam Tiger Reserve is located in the Andhra-Telangana border. So, when Andhra was existing as a full state, this was the largest tiger reserve in the nation. Now, Andhra was bifurcated. So, southern part of this tiger reserve is still called as Nagarjuna Srisailam and still it is the largest tiger reserve in the nation. The northern part is called as Amrabad Tiger Reserve. This Amrabad Tiger Reserve belongs to Telangana and this is the second largest tiger reserve in India. So, first and second largest tiger reserve are located in Andhra-Telangana border and Nagarjuna Sagar is the largest tiger reserve. So, recently this was in news because of the All India Tiger Estimation. We saw about the tiger census previously and Madhya Pradesh emerged as the largest state having largest tiger population. So, according to that tiger reserve, in the previous two censuses, the number of tigers present in this Nagarjuna Sagar was falling. But in the recent tiger census which was released in 2019, there was a growth in number of tigers in this protected area. So, there has been a growth in the number of tigers in this protected area. So, that's why it was in use. According to the fourth cycle of All India Tiger Estimation, there has been an increase in number of tigers in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. This number of tigers in NSTR in Andhra Pradesh has gone up. In 2006, there were 19 tigers. The number declined to 72 in 2010 and 68 in 2014. So, it is declining. Now, in the maiden tiger reserve, so this is the first tiger reserve after the bifurcation of the state. After the bifurcation of the state, they found that there are 48 tigers in Andhra Pradesh and 26 tigers in Telangana. Okay, together they sum up to how much? Together they sum up to more than 74. So, that's why it is in news. From 68, the number of tigers became 74. So, there has been an increase in number of tigers. So, it is the largest tiger reserve in India. The area consists mostly of Nallamalla Hills. So, you note down, when they are, if they are asking riddle type question, they can ask this. They can also ask in the March the following also. It is located in Nallamalla Hills. This tiger reserve gets its name from this reservoir. There is a reservoir called Nagarjuna Sagar Reservoir, which was constructed in Krishna River. So, this is the Krishna River. They constructed a Nagarjuna Sagar dam here. Because of this dam, there was a large reservoir called Nagarjuna Sagar Reservoir. So, this tiger reserve is surrounding this Nagarjuna Sagar. So, within this tiger reserve only, that dam is located. So, Krishna River passes through the Nagarjuna Sagar and Sri Sailam. So, this is the border. If you could see in this map, it is exactly located in the border. The southern area is Nagarjuna Sagar and northern area is Amrabad. The yellow thing here is the river. This is the Krishna River, and this Krishna River is actually acting as the border of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana till here. So, it is bifurcating the Nagarjuna Sagar Sri Sailam. The southern part is the largest tiger reserve in the nation. So, the next protected area in Andhra Pradesh is Papikonda National Park. This Papikonda National Park is was in use because of the recent butterfly census. Papikonda National Park is known for its fame, rich biodiversity of butterfly species. So, hence government decided to conduct a butterfly census. See, we are seeing a lot of censuses. We saw tiger census, news about tiger census, snow leopard census, and now we saw news about the bird census. We saw bird census in Ranganathittu, and now there is a butterfly census in Papikonda National Park. As many as 129 butterfly species have been recorded in this particular Papikonda National Park alone, and this was conducted by Andhra Pradesh State Department. This park lies in the left and right banks of the Godavari River. So, Papikonda, this park is actually located in the Papikonda Hills. The Godavari River passes through this park and it cuts the park into two. Like how Krishna River is passing through Sri Sailam, Godavari River passes through the Papikonda National Park. The majority of the park is moist deciduous. The previous two which we saw were dry deciduous, and this is moist deciduous forest. It consists of tiger, mouse deer and gaur. So, if you could see this is Papikonda National Park, and this is Godavari River, which is shown in yellow here. This Godavari River passes through this, and we are having the Papikonda Hills here. So, Papikonda Hills will be like this here. So, it is part of the Eastern Ghats. This Papikonda Hills is having significance in Ramayana also. This is the region where Kishkintha is located. So, you don't think Kishkintha is located in Tambaram. I am talking about the Kishkintha of the Sundarakandam. In Sundarakandam, Kishkintha is a place where Sugriva, Vali and Hanuman were there. So, this is where Ram meets Hanuman for the first time. So, that is a small trivia behind this, according to Ramayana epic. The last protected area which we are going to see for today is Atapaka Bird Sanctuary. This Atapaka Bird Sanctuary is located in the Kolleru Lake. It is located within the Kolleru Lake. You know Kolleru Lake is the delta region of two important rivers, that is Godavari and Krishna. Both the rivers come and meet here before mixing into the Bay of Bengal. So, Kolleru Lake is a freshwater lake located in the delta of two important rivers, and it is having a lot of lake island. So, one of that lake island is Atapaka Bird Sanctuary. You know, birds are fond of these wetlands. So, that see, if there is a lake, means this bird will come here and that bird will stand in this wetland and they will be hunting for the fish and other things in the water. So, this is how the wetland works, and that's why migratory birds prefer this wetland. They will come and stand in this water and they will be hunting the prey here. But what is happening, because of the good monsoon in the previous season, the water levels in the Kolleru Lake are rising, and hence the bird couldn't stand here. If the bird stands here, they will be drowning. So, this protected area is known for a near threatened species called grey pelicans. This grey pelicans and painted storks are two species which are visiting this bird sanctuary for nesting. But since the water level has risen, it is creating problem. So, what the government did was, since the water level has risen, so we cannot be going and silting it. We also need the water. So, what they did, they constructed the towers here for the birds to stand, so that the birds can stand and they can nest or breed or feed. So, for that purposes, what they are doing, they are constructing the towers like this with a stand for the bird to nest. So, that's why it was in news. Atapaka Bird Sanctuary is located in the Kolleru Lake and has become safe breeding ground for two migratory species of grey pelicans and painted storks. So, these two species are near threatened species. See, they have constructed the towers like this in the Atapaka so that they can stand here and they can do the nesting and breeding thing. So, that's why it was in news. So, this is Kolleru Lake located here. Good. So, this is Kolleru Lake. In this Kolleru Lake only, this is Krishna River and this is Godavari River. So, two important rivers are coming and forming the lake here. So, before joining into the Bay of Bengal. Okay. So, this is Atapaka Bird Sanctuary. So, thank you guys. We have come to the end of the fourth part. So, totally we have seen 40 protected areas in the news. And the final installment, the fifth part will be uploaded soon, which will be the final installment. In total, we would have seen the 50 protected areas in news for the past 1 year. So see all these videos and we can easily aim for that important 4 marks. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you.